Colleagues, listen, you have three catastrophic blood clots you have to know like the back of your hand. Watch me. You have stroke, heart attack, and PE. Cool? So we have three catastrophic blood clots. I don't care what field of medicine, you got to know each one of those. Okay. Now, the first thing I want to share with you is that a heart attack is a thrombus. That's different than an emboli. PE and AFib are emboli, or a PE, I'm sorry, and stroke are emboli. So what makes a difference here? Guys, a thrombus does not come on like this. A thrombus comes on gradually. When someone has a heart attack, they're not like, hey, they're like, I don't feel good. Well, what's going on? I just feel pressure burning. Well, how bad is it? 3 out of 10, because the clot's only 60%. 20 minutes later, the clot's now 70%. Now it's like a 7 out of 10. So colleagues, please listen. Acute coronary syndromes are crescendo pain. They get worse where stroke and PE come on like that. That's not a little thing, that's a big thing. How do you describe a stroke? Sudden onset of neurological deficit. How do you describe a PE? Sudden onset of chest pain or shortness of breath. But colleagues, I wanna put a little asterisk there. We're gonna talk about PEs. Small PEs can come on and feel semi-subacute. On the boards though, PEs come on like this, but I also don't want you to be disillusioned. Small PEs can seem subacute. So far so good, right? Mm-hmm. Now, we have big ones and small ones in each category. So do we agree we have a big stroke and a small stroke? So we have a CVA and a TAA. Mm-hmm. Now, let me ask you a question. When a big or small stroke comes in, how do we know initially which one it is? The answer is we don't know initially. We don't know initially. Because what's the difference between a CVA and a TAA? It's resolution of symptoms. Okay, so when they first come in, they look exactly the same. Do we agree? Now, when someone comes in with a heart attack, either a STEMI or non-STEMI, when they first come in, how can you tell the difference which one it is when they walk in? Until you have the EKG, you can't. So bottom line is, CVA and TAA present exactly the same. STEMI, non-STEMI present exactly the same. Now, this is where we get burned. There are two types of PEs, big ones and small ones. And if you don't know the difference between how they present, you will get burned. How do I know that? Because since I graduated PA school 26 years ago, I've done medical legal consulting. I only defend PAs. I will never be on the plaintiff side. So I won't attack any of you. I'll defend you. The most common thing I see is missed small PEs out of urgent cares. That's the most common thing that I see that goes home and have a detrimental outcome. Want me to tell you why the burn? You get burned so much is because there's big PEs and small PEs. They present so radically different. They're so different. It's not like stroke or MI. They present exactly the same. A big PE is radically different than a small one. And if you don't know how to be prepared for that, you get burned by the small ones. You won't by the end of this course.